All right, switching gears. A moment ago, in a previous segment with Minda Wilson, we talked about Obamacare and Trump Care. Staying on somewhat related subject, as you know, there's been a record number of U.S. soldiers returning from the battlefield in the Middle East with PTSD. Related to that somewhat is that research has shown that society has become more stressful than it has in past years. Perhaps it's because of the 24/7 information age. It's my hunch. It's become more stressful. We see more people with areas of depression. There is a new therapy out there introduced by my next guest in his clinic. It is called ketamine. And ketamine is treating those with PTSD, military or not, of course, those with depression, and those with stress. And again, stress levels are increasing in America. Let me introduce you to Sam Mandel. He's Chief Operating Officer of the Ketamine Clinics in Los Angeles. Good to see you, Sam.
Good to see you, Rick. Thank you for having me.
What is the ketamine therapy?
So ketamine infusion therapy. Ketamine infusion therapy is IV infusions. At our clinic, we do it intravenously. There are other routes of administration, but we do it exclusively IV and of the medicine ketamine to treat a variety of mood disorders, PTSD, depression, among others, as well as chronic pain conditions.
But what makes this different from other therapies out there?
That's a great question. So ketamine is originally an anesthetic. It's been around for over 50 years, and only very recently have we found it to be very effective for some of these new conditions and to be used in a different way than we traditionally have. And so it's got a variety of processes that occur in the brain that we're still researching thoroughly to fully understand. Some of them are that it causes an increase in a neurotransmitter known as glutamate. It's also a BDNF stimulator, which is brain-derived neurotrophic factor. So it actually can cause a physical growth in the brain and repair damaged cells.
All right. So so people go on your infusion therapy. Let's say they have PTSD. Let's say they're suffering from depression.
Right.
They go through your treatment. What can they expect? What differences can they expect to feel or experience in their life?
Yeah, so because of some of the processes I just mentioned, we see almost all of our patients come to us deemed treatment resistant. So they've tried lots of medications, SSRIs, SNRIs, atypical antipsychotics, all different types of oral medications, and even things like ECT or TMS in some cases, and they haven't benefited, or they've only minimally benefited from these things. And because ketamine works so differently, it works for them when nothing else has. And what can they expect, to answer your question? I mean, people see results very quickly, usually within a couple of hours or a couple of days.
Wow.
Unfortunately, we all know someone who, or have personally experienced depression. And it's pretty common that these medications take 4 to 6 weeks to work, if they work at all. And after waiting, you might have to adjust doses or combinations or try a new one. With ketamine, really quickly, hours to days, people see substantial relief.
Now, do you agree with my opening statement where I said that levels of stress and depression are increasing in America?
Yeah, I don't personally know about data on it, but I can tell you it definitely feels that way. I think that's a fair assessment.
Why do you think that is?
I think you really hit the nail on the head. You said this 24-hour workday. I mean, personally, I'm plugged in 24/7, emails, text messages, social media,
Yeah. My
personal life, professional. You're always expected to be on and available like 24/7. I know I sleep with my phone on, and I occasionally get calls or texts in the middle of the night, and it seems like we can never really unplug. And
yeah.
I don't think that's especially healthy.
Yeah, I would agree.
Yeah.
So the typical person that comes to see you,
yeah.
What's been their story, or is there a typical as to why they're going through what they're going through?
Yeah. So we see such a wide range. I also want to say, I didn't mention earlier, it's very, very effective for suicidality, and it can reverse suicidality in literally hours or days. There's really no other treatment for suicidality.
Suicidality, I haven't heard that phrase. I guess it means someone who's prone to suicide?
People who have suicidal ideation. So people who want to kill themselves, and there's a scale. It's not just one side or the other. There's a middle between wanting to just wishing you weren't here and having a means and a date set and having a very specific plan.
Mm.
We see a lot of people who really don't want to be here anymore, but they acknowledge that they wouldn't actually take action on it, and
yeah.
That's a horrible way to feel, of course.
Oh, yeah.
And so It's very, very effective for that as well.
What about the military? Are we seeing a lot of veterans with PTSD benefiting from this?
Yeah, and it's really remarkable for PTSD. That's how it was originally discovered. And unfortunately, with 140 people, or I think it's up to like 144 people committing suicide in the United States every single day, and 22 of them are service-connected.
Yeah.
And that's a really serious issue, and these brave men and women deserve to have something that works for them. And many of them feel very hopeless.
How did you guys come across, how did you develop this idea?
Yeah, so I work with my father, Dr. Stephen L. Mandel. He's a board-certified anesthesiologist. He has a master's degree in psychology, and I am the operations. I have done all the business, and he has done all the medical. And he's really kind of mastered this treatment as someone who's used ketamine extensively since it was first synthesized. And this is, as I mentioned earlier, this is a new use for an old medicine, and he really is impeccable with it.
Now, you're in New York, I keep saying New York City. You're in Los Angeles.
Yes, in Brentwood, yeah.
Brentwood. Yeah. What about our viewers across America? If this is of interest to them, perhaps they or someone they know is a returning veteran with PTSD, mm-hmm. perhaps they or someone they know is going through a tough time and mentally and or emotionally and are feeling bouts right. of depression, but they live in Texas or Florida right, or what right. have you. What is there any way they can access this?
Yeah, first I would let you know that we do see patients from all over the country. We have people come in, they stay at a hotel nearby, they can be in and out in a week. We see people from other countries too, New Zealand, Australia. We've had people from Saudi Arabia, even Thailand. Hmm. So we really do get people from all over the world who travel to us because of my father and the really impeccable work that he's doing and the team that we've built there to support this treatment. There are other clinics in the United States. I would be wary about making sure you have due diligence on which are really, skilled with this. As it's becoming more popular and gaining traction, there's a lot more people who are trying to do it who may not have the best intentions, or perhaps they have good intentions, but they don't have the competence, to be totally honest with you.
Okay, and Sam, is this something that's covered under the Affordable Care Act?
No, it's not. It's an off-label use. So ketamine is an FDA-approved medicine. It's been around and been approved for about 50 years, but this is an off-label use. One in four medications in the United States are used off-label, so it's very common. And it just means that it's been found to be effective for something other than what it was originally
All
intended
right.
for.
I got to rudely interrupt you and jump in there. All right, Sam Mandel, CEO of Ketamine Clinics Los Angeles. Important story. It's cutting edge.
It is.
We wanted our viewers across America to hear what you had to say.
Thank you so much, Rick.
All right, I'm Rick Amato, back with our panel. You will not believe the topics and the characters coming up next. Back after this.